My name is Robert. In this video, I will discuss the hydroxyl number and show you its determination by titration. The hydroxyl number or hydroxyl value is a key quality parameter for resins, paints, polyols, fats and oils. Let's start with some background information. The hydroxyl number is related to the amount of free hydroxyl groups in a sample. This information is needed for the quality control of finished products or further processing of raw materials. The hydroxyl number is defined as the number of milligrams of potassium hydroxide required to neutralize the acetic acid released from the acetylation of 1 gram of sample. There are 3 titration methods used for the analysis of the hydroxyl number. The original method, described in ASTM E1899 uses acetic anhydride and pyridine for the acetylation. It is necessary to reflux the sample for an hour and blank determinations are needed. This makes the method time consuming and difficult to automate. On top of that, toxic pyridine is used. 2 methods were developed to replace the pyridine and to run the acetylation at room temperature conditions. Because it is unnecessary to reflux the sample, these methods can be automated. The first improved method, described in EN ISO 4629-2, uses 4N-dimethylaminopyridine as catalyst. However, a blank determination is still necessary. Also, the acid number must be determined first, as it is needed to calculate the hydroxyl number. With an analysis time of about 40 minutes, this method is faster than the original method. The second method, described in ASTM E1899 and EN15168, uses TSI, para-toluene sulfonyl isocyanate, as catalyst. No blank determination is needed. And with an analysis time of about 12 minutes, the method is much faster than the others described earlier. Let's look at the automation possibility of this method. The sample size depends on the expected hydroxyl number of your sample. Then you only bring the sample rack to the OMNIS Sample Robot. Start your method and the beaker is brought to the workstation. You should use covered beakers, as additional moisture can falsify your result. TSI is added, which reacts with the hydroxyl groups of the sample to form an acidic carbamate. Water is added to convert the excess TSI to sulfonamide, so it won't interfere with the titration. Finally, the acidic carbamate is titrated with tetrabutyl ammonium hydroxide, also known as TBaOH. During the titration, 2 equivalence points, EP for short, are observed. EP1 corresponds to the acidic species in the sample. EP2 correlates to the acidic carbamate. The difference between EP2 and EP1 is used to calculate the hydroxyl number of the sample. After the titration, the sample beaker is automatically emptied and the titration head is cleaned with acetonitrile. The electrode is then rehydrated in deionized water. Afterwards, the electrode is again dipped into acetonitrile to remove any excess water. Fully automated determination of the hydroxyl number according to ASTM E1899 and EN15168 with an OMNIS sample robot from Metrom is fast, accurate, and reduces exposure to chemicals to a minimum.